Hello everyone, I'm excited to share this recipe for sourdough brioche with you. This bread is incredible, soft and fluffy, and way better than any other brioche breads I have baked with yeast. What a lovely day to bake. Moin, my name is Arne, German hobby baker who is living in Luxembourg. This recipe uses a stiff, sweet sourdough starter which gives the bread its distinct flavor and texture. The dough is also enriched with butter and eggs, which makes it extremely rich and decadent. The bread is baked until it's golden brown and perfectly fluffy. It has a cottony texture that's just begging to be torn apart and slathered with butter. The flavor is buttery, with a hint of sweetness. It's a perfect bread for any occasion, but it's especially good for breakfast and brunch. So let's get started. This is from Luxembourg with Loaf. The evening before we want to bake, we create our stiff starter with 110 grams of wheat flour, 55 grams of water, 5 grams of sourdough starter and 15 grams of sugar. You mix everything up with a spoon and later you use your hands because, as the name implies, it's a stiff starter. So roll everything on your countertop and mix it with your hands until the water is completely dissolved. Place it back in your container and this will stay overnight at room temperature. The next morning you see the volume has more than doubled and that's a good sign. For the main dough we need 220 grams of wheat flour and 70 grams of milk as well as 2 eggs. We need our stiff sourdough starter. And then we add 45 grams of sugar. Then we mix everything by hand. You can of course use a mixer and I would actually recommend using a mixer because this dough is really, really sticky. After everything has been mixed, cover it with a plastic wrap and leave it rest for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, it's time to add the butter and salt. We need 80 grams of butter as well as 5 grams of salt. And then it's time to mix everything again. Once everything is mixed, cover it with a plastic wrap and leave it rest for another 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you see the gluten development has started and that's a good sign. We now want to enhance this process by doing a lamination. So therefore we place the dough on the countertop and then we pull it from the middle to the sides. Of course, if you're using a mixer, you can of course skip all of these steps because you have already combined everything and the gluten is perfect already. And once you feel the resistance, then pull everything back to the middle. Then you shape a ball again and then put it back into your container. You can use a dough scraper if there is some sticked dough on the countertop. Later, it's time for doing some stretch and folds. And you see the gluten development is a little bit better than before. So pull the dough from one side over the top of the dough to the other side. And then repeat that for 6 to 8 times until you feel the resistance. And then place the plastic wrap again over the bowl and then let it rest for another 30 minutes.
30 minutes later, it's time to divide our dough into three pieces. I'm using here a kitchen scale, as we Germans want to be precise with everything, but of course you can also divide the dough into three pieces. And then roll the dough with a rolling pin, fold it, and then roll it again. And then roll the dough up. And try to create some tension when rolling it up. And then place it into your loaf pan. I have, by the way, greased the loaf pan a little bit with oil so it won't stick. And once this has been done, cover it, and then this will ferment for about 4 hours.
While the sourdough is rising, please take a moment to connect. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. I'll be posting more sourdough recipes soon, so you don't want to miss them. And if you want to be notified as soon as I upload a new video, be sure to enable notifications. Thanks.
So 4 hours later, you see that the size has been not doubled, but at least it increased quite a lot. So it was time now to give it a little egg wash. I have mixed up an egg with some milk, and as I was baking other things at that day and I had not so much egg, I was using more milk. So cover it again, and then it's time already to preheat your oven to 180 degrees Celsius, that's 356 degrees Fahrenheit. And after 30 minutes it's time to bake it, so put it in the oven. I would recommend opening the lid and then bake it with steam for 40 minutes, and this is what it looks like, really really nice. We don't need to cut it, we can just tear it apart. Wow, super fluffy and cottony texture. And enjoy these lovely pictures. Have fun when you bake it. Bon appetit.
So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed learning how to make sourdough brioche and you got the desire to bake this recipe directly. I promise you will not regret it. What other sourdough recipes you would like to see me make? Write me a comment below the video. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. Adieu and goodbye.